the game, and it's just it looks like, you know, they're getting out those little early wards. Did that ward miss? I think it did miss. Yep, they potentially, no, I'm not sure. I can't tell if Graves, yeah, I think Graves did miss the ward. Unfortunately for him.
Yeah, sorry about that. People are just making me very, very aware that we could not see the stream. So,
yeah, that's yeah. It was because I got a request to increase their mini map size. You see, so that's been scaled up now.
Challenger Chiron, aka so, Power of Phoenix, aka Puff Daddy.
All right. So yeah, don't like much is gonna happen at this point. Looks like Maokai might actually be starting the Wraith camp, which is you know a common thing for Maokai. Just getting out them saplings.
Yeah, just getting out the one sapling for safety. And then, you know. Is that even a sapling top, or is it a ward? I believe it's a sapling.
Yeah,
he dropped a sapling to cover the invade, and then just planted the rest at Raptors.
Yep. So he'll be hitting level 2 nice and quickly.
Oh, crap. I dealt a lot more damage than I anticipated.
Oh, I need to slot the champions as well. That's something I should probably do. Where's all these junglers?
Well, you're sorting them out now.
Yep, there we go. That shouldn't take too long.
It should have been done, like, ages ago.
Ah, it's fine. Right, so...
No one noticed, don't worry.
Alright,
so... yeah.
So
the first thing that's different, I think, from the past few games is that we've got a Relic Shield versus the Spell Thief. I'm pretty sure in most of them, the supports have actually had identical support items. In the other two that we've cast so far, because I believe first game it was the coin, last game they both had spell thieves, and now we've got a differential. So,
no relic shields yet, then. Oh, that's gonna be knocking me down already. Going over to Jinx in Graves' state to fight there, had to burn the flash.
He wouldn't have been able to walk out either, though. That was the problem because of the chompers. So,
yeah.
Yeah, he had to burn that flash there. Vi getting incredibly low actually in the jungle.
Yeah, incredibly low.
That's not like Vi. Cho'Gath.
Maokai.
Yeah, Cho'Gath's getting incredibly aggressive on.
Though, there is the advantage for Cho'Gath. One, yeah. He's got that extremely, you know, regenerative. Wait, let me try that again. I'm gonna give up. he's got that passive that does regen, yeah.
But so they both have it, so.
That is true. Well,
Maokai has to cast spells, but.
And punch stuff. Cho'Gath can just, like, slap him.
Well, he has to kill the minion, though, so.
Yeah, shut up. So, Maokai not having the ignite didn't pay off for him at this point. We have to see how he uses teleport, and he just looks like he's. Wait, he's already used it? He's teleported to lane.
Yeah, because he teleported after killing the race, didn't he, so.
Ah, of course.
Cho'Gath did have to actually burn his ignite in that engage a second ago to, you know, try and push Maokai off. That was, like, I'm assuming the main use there. It's like, you know, just to get a little bit of extra damage. Say, okay, I understand that you're being aggressive, but can you not do that, mate? Basically.
Can you give it a rest?
Can you refrain from hitting me? Oh, the Nami Ball does actually connect.
They both did not expect that to land. You could tell.
Yeah, no one reacted.
Instantly walked away from the trade. Graves only got like one auto, I think, after that.
Yeah, it was a Nami enhanced auto, but you know, yeah. Only one auto, the same. Jarvan
is literally slapping this Cho'Gath around.
Yeah,
like nobody's business.
He managed to juke the J4 flag and drag.
He's trying to kill the Cho, and he's. the rupture there from the Cho'Gath.
I think I know what he was doing, but if he'd have just
trying to get a super jump from the knock up.
He was trying to predict the Maokai landing the root, so that he could knock him up. But it did. Yeah, Maokai got too scared in the end of the Jarvan and just didn't go for it.
He could have cast rupture, and it would have like he could have cast it just after he cast his. Oh, what is it? Grasping? It's not Grasping Roots, is it? That's Zyra.
I have no idea what Maokai's snare is actually called. Maokai's jumpy thing. His root.
So when he used his jumpy thing,
it's called Twisted Advance, of course.
Twisted Advance, that's the one. and he's just like completely stuck, especially like versus the Jinx and the Chompers. But you know, Cho'Gath made a tactical decision. Unfortunately, it didn't pay off. Oh, they're backing it at almost the exact same time. That shows synergy. That means that you're going to be great in duo queue, guys. That even if you never played together before, you should duo queue ranked right now.
In the middle of this game.
Yeah, that's how most of my ranked games go.
Oh, the soft is real.
Let's see, so the CS is looking pretty even across everyone except for mid lane.
Across the board.
Mid lane's there's a slight difference, but that's because the Diana aggression is forcing Lux to play way safer. And under tower, Lux isn't the greatest last hit, unfortunately.
Yeah, not the best. Whereas Diana, you know, that passive.
Yeah.
I mean, Lux has a similar passive, not really.
Yeah, she has to actually use abilities in order to actually use hers.
Like Leona, kind of crap. Well, Leo can do it basic as well, can't she?
No,
she can't.
And Leona can't pop her own, whereas Lux can.
Yeah. It's sexism when you think about it.
Well, I mean, they're both women, but.
Oh, and Maokai completely outplayed.
Yeah, he's just juking around.
Making him look a bit silly, if I'm quite honest. And he's trying to redeem himself with. Oh wait, no, he is redeeming himself, never mind. The Nidalee from yesterday was Maokai.
Yeah.
So he's actually redeeming himself today. However, I will say, Maokai is considerably easier to play than a Nidalee.
Maybe, but at the end of the day, champion being easier, don't matter if it's more effective.
Oh, the wise words of St. Owen coming out. You can buy his autobiography.
Gonna have like an inspirational photograph thing
of League, and that is about the seventh rupture in a row that I've seen this Cho'Gath miss.
Okay, so Diana is looking in a pretty bad position. Oh, failed flash.
Yes, failed the flash.
Can Nami save Diana though here?
And Thresh ends the kill.
Yeah, Thresh ends up with the kill.
Honestly, that might be more in favor even of Red Team, because they even burn Jinx's flash at the end of that engage, and all they lost were, well, they lost the mid laner, but it went to the support.
Yeah, but and they burnt the support's exhaust flash, Jinx's
both
flash and heal.
Both of Brian's bot laners had no summoners.
Yeah, they used all of their summoners.
No ults, no summoners
within that engage.
And one of them is half HP under tower. But Drake is live, and it has been since the start of the game. Again, not many early dragons in the games that we've cast.
No,
so
not really. I mean, maybe as the week goes on.
Not be putting the priority on it that it deserves.
Yeah, I feel like. That was a combo.
Absolutely beautiful.
And that's going to secure Diana
that
a nice skill in the mid lane.
Oh, that was amazing. I'm watching that back on the second monitor. I'll be back in a second.
That was pretty nice to see.
So, Vi misses the Vault Breaker, but then Diana pulls her into it, and chainable CC.
Oh, you missed. You got it. You got it. You just missed that.
Oh,
so
I'm just gonna live this game.
Greaves.
In,
you can't do that. Greaves managing to kill Thresh under the tower with his ultimate after hitting level 6. You got to be careful with that burst.
Now. Oh, LCS big plays swoop de whoop.
Right, jump
well,
to. You can jump to live now. There's nothing else that's happened.
Yeah. I was watching it on the, because the stream slightly delayed.
Oh, you actually, I see.
I've got the stream open as well, because you know, I'm just like baller, like that.
Yeah, you see, it's because you have two monitors. Rest in peace me. but, yeah, so Lux is getting a blue buff.
To Owen for second monitor.
Yeah, so look, Lux,
£6 a month.
Lux and Diana both have their blues, so there's going to be a lot more poking going on, I guess, in this lane now. Might help Lux under tower too.
Yeah, I'll be fine.
G4, he's like, oh, there's a pink here.
He's like, oh, I want it.
I got some money.
Diana. That is.
Yeah, Diana's trying for it.
Femininity destroyed the last remaining shrapnel, the pink flower, in the lane.
Are you okay?
I'm great, mate.
That was some little poetry right there. Poetry corner. So yeah, I mean I feel like the red team should be looking for the dragon. I feel like Vi is behind CS, like she's had more of an impact on the game, and the bot lane, although Jinx realistically is ahead, like Graves has slightly more CS and he has just as many kills. I mean, look at that, that trade.
In the 1v1. Oh!
And there you go.
See, I would have preferred it if he cast ult first, then killed him with gas gun.
Yeah, the smoke screen kill. Oh, and there comes the Maokai TP gang. That is going to take that looks
just ridiculous.
Yeah, and so.
You know, because they didn't really pay attention to him much, his ult damage isn't going to be that potent, unfortunately.
Oh no, it's anyone in his team.
That takes that, yeah, but they weren't hitting either of them, were they?
Well, they were trying to run away, I guess. But
cowering.
But yeah, so they are gonna just clear that dragon out, and yeah, they should. Are they not? They're not gonna clear it.
The ward. Cool.
Okay, there we go.
Good job, buddy.
Ah, oh, there's another one. Maokai, clear it quick. Nami.
These sick mechanics. Too many wards. Oh. Watch. Oh, I was waiting for the fresh steel.
The fresh hook steel.
I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, like, but
fucking just throw up the gates, and it's just like.
Yeah, but you gotta remember, Threshook is way too magnetic. You just end up pulling a champion instead.
Nah, mate. Nah, like if you're basically Gosu with Cleaver, so like Mad Life, you can weave those hooks like the threading needle, just like swoosh, and then you get all of the ADC booty in the form of Jinx if you manage to pull it off. Oh, I shouldn't be having that fight. That's really bad.
Okay, so bot, the blue side bot lane, probably gonna get this turret, I assume, because you know Jinx. No, Greaves just about gonna hold this, maybe. Oh no, he does actually end up having to give it up, and he's gonna die for it, I think, too now. Oh, I was wrong.
He gets the kill.
Oh, and he might.
There's a Nami coming through.
Oh my God, the flash heal.
Absolutely real, this Nami.
Oh, is this Lust Boy?
Why Nami is the best support that was ever created.
Was that Lust Boy though? That flash, the flash
that
saves. Oof.
Nah, Lust Boy's not even that good, mate. Like, come on.
No, don't be silly.
Come on now.
you know that he's the Nami god.
Yeah, but I've never seen him, so like, I wouldn't know.
Right. So, Vi. Aggressive plays, I don't know what's going on there. They're just after that one Wraith.
Nami sick heal there, MVP.
Oh.
Oh, dying for. Insane.
Oh, ooh, that was a weird. The dash just didn't go all the way. Oh,
he's got the flash. Hashtag bug kill and.
Oh, again dunked. Don't know why you wouldn't. Oh, the looks there as the Vi, but.
So, just whatever. Courage. Bush Lover got hacked, basically, didn't he? There was a bug, and so someone hacked him, and he shouldn't have died there.
Maokai,
he was like, well, what are you saying?
I don't know what that was, he just kind of walked at his side for a little bit. He didn't really do anything.
The turn, but again, this guy, dude, I know it might be quite a difficult skill shot, but well, it's not really. But like, it's just. Oh, he's landed one!
Oh, he's going in! It's all in!
He's going in! Oh, the flash! The flash!
The double flash! Oh!
Oh, he's getting juked though! The rupture!
Oh! Hey!
Landed two ruptures in a row!
There's the results! It's the results of landing the ruptures.
Do you know what it is? It's my constructive criticism in saying that he's been bad all game.
He heard it, he was like, wait a minute, no, I'm not having this.
It's like when Krillin dies, so Goku can become Super
Whoa,
Saiyan.
Whoa, spoilers, man!
Oh shit, mate, I spoiled it. Oh, it's unfortunate. Speaking of Super Saiyans, J4 is in the bot lane and about to go Kamehame, jump on someone.
Yeah, but Diana Rizzo, and Vi.
Debate arenas.
Diana and Vi are also both there.
Down, a lot of bursts going on too. Graves is dropped, but killed
fresh.
The fresh. Diana,
yeah, fresh again.
Diana's still going strong. J4's gonna go down for the double. Now they're chasing onto Thresh. Will they give the triple? Diana kinda deserved it. But, and there he goes.
Yep.
Triple kill. Fourth one of the day, I believe.
Like, this triple kill, it's gonna put Diana pretty far ahead now. Like, I mean, she's already winning the lane against Lux, so that's just basically just steamrolled the advantage right there. Being 4-1, yeah, there you go, getting a needlessly large rod on the recoil, so the damage.
With the abyssal already,
yeah,
like built, like they've got nothing to do with his Diana. They don't have an Aegis. Like, to be fair, it's only 16 minutes in the game, but they don't have an Aegis.
I mean, I'm just wondering, is that is Thresh already on it? Is Thresh already on the Aegis? Look, he's got the new magic and the Ruby Crystal.
He's going for it.
He knows.
Thresh is aware.
He's ahead.
He's like, yo, we can't allow this Diana.
Look, they're passing the blue buff to Cho'Gath.
Oh yeah, man, like, because like he's missed quite a lot of ruptures, he needs more mana to keep spamming it.
But Lux is now gonna miss out on that blue. I don't think that was the right choice, personally.
Don't worry, man. Oh, he landed one.
He's got it.
In a row. This is crazy.
Oh,
but he get dove?
What's going on here?
He's getting
now,
turned around onto the
Maokai is
kinda got bait arena. Oh, he goes for the Graves instead, but now he's got to focus on the Diana.
Yeah, J4 is.
Duke,
oh, they
so
gave the kill to Graves with the.
Maokai,
no.
Kill onto Maokai, but the Graves coming in from behind just going to pick up the cheeky kill for the double. But,
oh my god, yeah, that Vi damage on Jinx.
Normally getting, you know, Duke Arena a little bit, but ultimately, the wave was pretty good.
Vi's damage just then was pretty crazy.
Yeah, she's, I didn't mean to mention earlier, she's gone for the Warrior in champion.
Yeah, both actually have gone for Warrior.
He's going for a Brutalizer as well for the double CDR armor pen.
Oh, Diana's so, looking for that cheeky kill.
She don't need no tank stats. That'd be crazy.
Diana's waiting, look. She wants that Lux.
Will she get it? No. She's backing off now towards the Baron area. Yeah. Dragon spawning in 3 seconds.
Neo team are rarely around it properly at the minute. The red side has the vision.
Baron's spawning in 155.
Oh! Thresh clearing that ward over the wall.
What a monster.
He's like, I don't care.
LCS, big plays. Of all the ones we've seen today, Thresh is the most important. Oh, what is he doing? He takes out a second!
Oh.
What a legend.
Oh, he can't get that third. Unfortunate.
J4's not even going to go in for the steal, is he? Nah. Why are so many people trying to kill it with a Jinx rocket? Like, they see Wild Turtle do it, like, 3 times, and they think it's easy.
I mean,
it's actually quite hard to do it with a Jinx rocket, because you don't get the damage on monsters or minions. You may as well try.
Well, Diana's just gonna kill everyone now.
Speaking of Jinx, she's blowing up, and that is 2 kills going over the Potatoes. I have to say, a much stronger showing than what they had yesterday.
Yeah, definitely improved from yesterday's showing.
Maybe not pick Nidalee.
is that the key? Oh my god, the Graves! That was some aggression right there. He's like, I ain't having you being near this turret.
See,
get out of here.
Lucian from last game, this is the damage that you could have if you built IH first.
No, but double armor pen.
Double armor pen, get all those skill shot kills. Graves all walking off the tower. Is he gonna have dash? He's gonna have dash right again. Ooh, again very soon, but it's a good thing he turned back.
Yeah, he managed to dodge the hook.
Brian actually chasing, they could potentially pick up the kill on Maokai here, he's got no mana.
He's definitely going down.
Jinx. And Cho'Gath wants this.
Oh, that was some damage.
Just misses because of the heal from Graves, and he decides to back off.
After flashing.
I feel like they could have chased that maybe a little further.
Yeah, probably. Jinx is about to come up soon, so if Diana does recall there, and Jinx, like, you know, just takes a little guess, it is easily possible. But looks like they're not going to bother with the Jinx rocket.
See, I think you're forgetting that Sam Dope was Challenger last season. So he doesn't guess. That's why he didn't guess to take an ultimate. Because if he goes for an ultimate, he gets the kill. I mean, not this game. But like, probably in some of the games. At some point, probably. He got the kill. Here's hoping. God bless.
So... Red team, they're kind of just bunching around like mid right now. Oh, but there's not really much for them to fight. I mean, there's the open inhibitor, but they'd have to win the fight first. But I don't know, I feel like they're actually in a position where they could go for a Baron if they felt comfortable doing so. They're far enough ahead. So it just means, you know, getting the vision and clearing out the enemies. But as you can see, currently there is literally no wards around the Baron area at all. The closest is the Riverbrush from mid lane. So it's a pretty visionless area, because I guess is a so. Oh, that Diana is just getting some little chunks off with them Qs.
Them cheeky chunks. Oh, and half HP.
Oh man, yeah, that's a dead look.
Cho'Gath just kind of like poking her, like very politely, though he does get the shutdown with the ultimate. Now they peel for the Jinx, get onto the Vi.
Yep.
The rupture was quite nice there to cut her off. Jinx rocket will ultimately pick up that kill. Oh, flashing the bubble, thinks he's a G. The rupture's gonna land.
That is gonna be dead.
Popping in the chaos, and
however,
the screaming shout will take her down.
Yeah, top lane. We have a Graves.
And a Maokai now. I mean, yeah, they'll get it, I suppose.
They won't be able to actually get the inhibs. But, you know, at least now, you know, they're both open, so.
Three kills for an inhib tower, I mean.
At this point, I think it's fine, because they're so far ahead.
For them, it's. For them, it's terrible. The blue team is terrible.
Oh, yeah. Like, Brian did not want to take that trade, really. I mean, you know, three kills, it would look good. Until they lost that inhib turret. But.
I think you know, someone stopped the ports, because I know they were backing. I could not tell you off the top of my head. Okay, throwing his little soccer balls out. Like, hey, here's a football.
Have fun.
There you go. And there was Thresh graciously accepting that football.
Oh. Jinx, they found Jinx, but they're not going to do
anything. Fish and chips, it would seem, and completely misses the bubble. The max range hook from Thresh coming out. Jinx going to pick up a second hit potentially on Diana.
Yep, that is going
to
be a
Jinx.
Kill. Yeah, this is
why I get greedy and smell the Thresh.
You see, this is becoming a problem because Jinx now has 5 kills, and as we've mentioned several times, you know, the hyper carry potential of Jinx.
Definitely.
With 5 kills.
This is the first team Jinx has been on today where she's had a team that was like, I don't know, like very, very good at defending them. Like, they can go in and just not die, and then if they're forgetting about Jinx at the back like this, then great. Oh, will the tick off? Oh, I'm gone. And it
the
goes
ult is
Jinx
gonna
again with the ult.
I also want to recap. Cho'Gath is actually 4-1 right now.
Yeah.
So definitely redeeming himself.
I told you. He was like, oh, Android 16 Sama, you know, he won't recognize me, what can I do? Senpai, please. And then he was like, oh, okay, I'll land some keys. I don't even know what half that stuff is that I just said. I just heard you and Jack say it so many times. Actually terrible.
So, I feel like if this game continues the way it's going, that Brian will actually have a very, very good chance of winning this game. Like, Jinx is now just as strong as Graves.
Yeah,
and,
I mean,
you know, the Cho'Gath is way tankier.
Lux is basically just like AoE damage and like utility at this stage. There for the CC. But three Drakes is a problem.
Yeah.
Though, you know, do believe, hashtag 3 not 5.
I thought it was 4 not 5.
It was actually 3 not 5, but I changed it to 4 not 5.
Oh, I see.
Earlier today, just to fit the occasion. See, because that's what I put on my CV. I'm like, I can think on the spot, and I can make those key decisions that might, like, make or break a company.
Oh, God. So, they're all slowly moving towards the Baron. You know, they're all roaming
Night
around
God,
that area.
That guy. I got championship Riven skin code from here. It's like, ban him, Nightbot.
Is he not doing it?
No, he's not doing it. It's like, he's slacking hard.
He's being cheeky.
Cheeky Nightbot is cheeky. Madness.
But, yeah. I think. Like,
no one clicked that link. Just.
Oh, in fact, yeah, the. Potatoes have got like way more.
You probably should have clicked on.
They've got way more vision over that Baron side. Except none of it's actually at the point where, you know, they can actually see the Baron. So, oh no, the blue team can still easily take that Baron without.
Not entirely sure why they're swinging around Dragon area. Like.
I think they're
really
just.
I mean, bot lane's pushed in, but.
I'm not sure if they're looking to try and teamfight with Maokai being top lane, but he does have the TP up, so.
That's true. They probably are forgetting about that TP advantage as well with Maokai. But if they can keep this up, they're just going to lose both inhibs. If they lose a fight, that's at least one inhib down.
Maokai is recalling.
Cho'Gath maybe a bit.
Yeah, Cho'Gath's going to just get slowed.
Oh! Jupiter's coming out from Graves, predicting the prediction.
But the Fresh Lantern's there anyway to save, so.
Thresh Prince coming to save the day.
I assume that Maokai's now got. Yep, there's the Righteous Glory for Maokai.
Honestly, you should have probably built it first. It would have helped him far more in lane with the Catalyst.
Yeah. I'm surprised that
Spirit's Visage is good, but not first item good.
I'm surprised that neither of the two picked up a Rod of Ages either. Like one of the like either Rod of Ages or the Righteous Glory is a first item.
Cho'Gath didn't pick either. I mean, if we look at the player board now, it looks even that Thresh is going to be the one to purchase the Righteous Glory.
Yep, that does look like it's going to be the case. I mean, I do like it on champions like Thresh and Blitzwing. You know, the supports that have you got to catch people off guard with it. And it's like, you know, suddenly just come speeding at people, gives them less chance of dodge a hook. Yeah, there you go. So both teams now actually do have a good vision on Baron. I mean, the red team are aware that the blue team is here, and I'm pretty sure Maokai is now currently clearing the ward. So, blue team has now lost all of their vision on Baron from that one ward being taken away. The little wolf spirit.
Have you seen Kieran in the chat?
No, I haven't got the chat open.
I clicked it. I now own Championship Riven. Excellent banter. Excellent.
So.
And Elixir of Iron on Cho'Gath.
Yeah, he just popped that now. He's ready for the fight, he knows.
He went Super Saiyan. This guy's ready.
Maybe about to happen.
Question is. Oh, the potatoes. I'm sorry, I can't say that. I say that name differently every time I say it. I can't decide on the pronunciation.
Potatus, potatus.
Yeah.
It's something like that.
Potatus, yes. Amalis. Oh, Rupture Mist. Typical.
Oh, but he did manage to land the silence onto Graves. Maokai coming in from behind.
Take the fight to them. I mean, Banner is on Jinx.
Yep, this could be bad.
She's shut down. This is going to be very bad for them now. Cho'Gath is the most fed member on their team, but. He maybe should have stayed and had more faith in his jungler. I mean, there was a lot of time there when Cho'Gath and Lux were just doing nothing to the enemy team. They kind of just left J4 to die.
J4 actually did manage to make it out, believe it or not.
Exactly. Like, if they would have stayed and fought, I mean, Cho'Gath got a kill out of it. I mean, he died, but he got a kill. So if he would have, like, actually put out damage whilst the J4 was trapping them, then... Yeah, maybe they would have come out with a bit more favourable trade instead of losing
to
a disadvantage. Yeah, a disadvantageous amount of kills and doing hibs.
Well, Lux laser does like no damage.
Yeah, Lux just throws out the laser like, okay. I mean, he's basically got a Doran's blade, so like he's super tanky. So
too tanky.
He's too tanky. And Jinx Rocket out. Not.
Stops the recalls.
Are they stopping the ports?
Maokai did. I don't think Maokai was paying any attention.
Are they trying to rush Baron? Were they trying to like? Then again, Jinx might have been aiming for Baron.
Yep. That's also a possibility.
It was like
they are going for the Baron, and Maokai is recalling.
I do want it to go down to a 50-50 smite war. I don't want Diana to ruin it, but of course, you know, that champion just ruins my life, so... I'm not going to get the spoiler war that I wanted. Which is, not very great.
Everyone's just going to leave that be for now. Dragon is also available right now, so,
Yep.
I would assume Red Team to be going for that.
Is it going to be hashtag 4 not 5 very soon? Or is it going to be hashtag 1 the dream? I prefer, it doesn't look like, which one I prefer, but Drake is unfortunately going down exponentially fast. That was not the right word to use.
The only way this is going to be stolen now is the Lux laser currently, because Jigsaw was down. Lux did walk out of way out of range though, so.
Magic. I do want Jinx to like at least steal something though, like. Even if like it's just stealing a kill at this point, I just want to see a bit of theft.
Some like, good old thievery.
GTA League. Or Grand Theft League.
Just tanking then, them like, super minions. Oh.
You steal kills and then you don't pay your bills.
You know, surprisingly both Jinx and Graves are still rather even. Graves is only a slight amount of gold ahead, having the completely finished boots, and the QSS to Jinx Berserker's Greaves with no enchantment and a Bam Scepter. So, with all of that gold lead that they had earlier on, Jinx has actually made a significant catch up.
Yeah, he's only about what, 2k behind? Let me just quickly check the gold graph. Oh! Like, barely a K.
Yep. So,
like 1.6, I think.
That's going to be the Baron for Patatus. You know, they're going to probably just recall, get some items, and come back. And I imagine they'll be looking to end the game right now with that Baron buff. Because they have two inhibs currently down. So, going to bot lane, push those towers in, and, you know, end it from there. Diana finds Jarvan, but nothing really happens with those two. There's just some miskill shots, and then they're left. Diana's gonna now take away the blue. Come on, Diana, you already had your own blue buff. You could have shared that. Nothing wrong with that. Let the enemies have it.
Not the sharing type.
No, clearly not. So, Graves is bringing the minions in. We're gonna be seeing this tower go down pretty fast, I assume. At the bottom lane. And will they continue the push? Or no, Diana's actually off at top lane. So they're splitting right now.
They want to push the minions. Yeah. They want to threaten the Nexus Towers.
So they can get an easier push, but that's the question is will that lead to a bad team fight? With Diana stuck at the top side.
Potentially. I don't really think that Vi and Maokai, if they both jump to the Jinx, that they could kill him alone. They need the damage of Diana.
Oh my god, Graves are getting chumped.
Absolutely.
He might be going down.
They do trade for the kill onto the J4.
But an AD carry for J4.
Taking a lot of damage. But again, trying to turn Jinx though, not hitting anything.
She did, she had to flash the bubble, but... Oh, the Chompers hits too.
And the focus is switched to Diana.
Diana's just going to take down Jinx now. Well. The rupture comes in. Thresh taking the kill. They need to go back and defend the base.
Was a promising start to a team fight. Just again, just it ended poorly for Team Brian.
Yeah, I mean the problem for them is that they're so far behind now that fighting a team with Baron, it's always going to be difficult, even when they have like an extra player. So. I mean, they managed to take the AD carry and the mid laner down, which is basically the two damage dealers, but obviously that also delayed the push, but it wasn't overall a massive triumph. So,
definitely. Oh, it looks like the Nami's having connection issues again.
Yep, so...
We may see a pause come out here.
Depends how long they take to reconnect. And if they reconnect at all.
There we go.
So, not a pause-worthy disconnect there. So, just having probably some small lag issues that they wanted to sort out. How long? So we got the fifth dragon coming up in 1:30. So the blue team are gonna have to contest this, unfortunately for them. Like, even though they don't really want to be fighting.
Otherwise, it is basically game.
Yeah, the game is pretty much over if Patatas get this.
I mean, I'm really surprised they've not, like, played better around this Cho'Gath ultimate, around the Drake specifically.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, it's going to start becoming a non-factor because it doesn't actually, it's going to be coming to the point where it does, the smite would do just as much anyway. But
yeah,
if they can communicate correctly, you know, he can chunk it down with his ult and then get the J4 smite, it's definitely advantageous. Some little, just a bit of poke going onto Maokai, not really much to bother him really there, but
Gash again taking those pink wards over the wall.
He knows where it's at, he wants that money.
We've never seen.
Another big problem.
15 seconds.
I feel for Team Brian.
Cho'Gath isn't even there, does not have the TP either, or the home guard.
Yeah, that could mean that this dragon is probably like going to be a free one. Yeah, a main problem for Team Brian is that if you look at the mid lane matchup, currently, like, the CS has just skyrocketed out of control in comparison. Like, there's
yeah, I've noticed that with a lot
like
100
of
solo laners in this tournament so far. Like, the difference between solo laners is just ridiculous in some games.
So maybe that's something they'll need to look at. Maybe it was just the Jinx pick.
They
you,
need
like,
to get
know.
Into the pit. That Drake is dropping way too
yeah.
fast.
If they can't steal this, that is going to be
oh,
the game.
J4,
he does manage to get it.
But it may just cost them the game anyway.
Well, so far they have actually
no
the advantage in the fight.
On
oh,
the backline.
Yeah, but neither no one was getting Jinx.
Jinx is getting the double. He won't. I don't believe he'll be able to survive off of the Maokai with him sticking to it. But he's going to get the triple onto Graves. Unofficial triple, whereas Graves gets an official one.
Well, unluckily,
there's
that
only one standing. Can he get away? Are the Krugs there to lead him to safety? No, but I do believe.
I
means
don't feel
an inhibitor.
I don't feel that Maokai can push much more than an inhibitor. I mean, it's gonna take him a very long time to push that because it's Maokai after all, and he has literally no damage in his build, so I mean, Thresh might even actually be able to delay him.
The sad moment when he realizes he can't take an open inhibitor with no one there.
Because
wow.
Thresh will actually come and stop that. Nami is actually having to struggle to defend an inhib tower at top lane. So, and her team are just completely ignoring it too. So, Vi and Diana, you know, both of them just going to the mid lane. One of them should probably help Nami. But, oh well. There we go. Diana's just realised, she's like, oh. Oops.
Nah, Nami has double buffs, so.
Yeah, it's
she doesn't
fine.
Need any kind of help.
Alright, so. Yeah, after that, so I mean, they did manage to delay the fifth dragon. So that's useful for them, but now, once again, Baron's back on the cards. As Ash literally just spawned now. So. I'm pretty sure Red Team are aware of this, and they're going to be heading for that any time now. Especially with no vision at all from Team Brian around this. Yeah, they're just going to go ahead and start. And Team Brian won't even know that it's going down.
Pretty much just like the rest of the game, they had like no objective control. They're clinging to the game just because the Jinx has pretty decent positioning in this fight, and to be honest, Vitaly's just aren't focusing her enough. Like she's had to cast flash here, and like the Diana's not even entered the fight yet. This is going to be quite risky for the Jinx if she gets caught up on. But she's just deleting through the team,
yeah.
So it doesn't even matter.
I feel like if she stays with Thresh and the Thresh is able to peel effectively, then this could easily like turn the game. Like, they have to all just be peeling for Jinx at this point. That's like the only way they're going to win this game.
Cho'Gath is dealing a moderate amount of damage.
he's off on that turret.
Split push Cho'gath is actually being much more useful than the split push Maokai.
I feel like Diana should have cleared the minions there instead of going onto Cho'gath. She might have been able to save that turret, even if it was only a small amount of health. It'd mean that they would still have to push the resources back up there again.
Yeah, and they're still denying the global call as well.
Yeah, exactly, but. Oh well. I mean, it was going to go down eventually, right? But, you know. So, both AD carries, the builds, in fact, the builds are pretty much identical right now. Except for, we've got the good old blue trinket on the Graves, with just a standard.
Also, the boot enchantments are slightly different.
Yeah, well.
With the Jinx taking home guard. Pretty much on his own, no one even close to him.
One problem for the blue team is that there's not a single upgraded trinket at this point of the game, 40 minutes into the game.
The thing that doesn't matter is they're not going to need them at this point when it's 4v5 but an open inhibitor. And you were talking about the Thresh defending Jinx, but can't do that from the grave.
I mean, they still.
Graves just going to absolutely decimate that inhibitor.
They still have, like, Cho'gath.
Onto
like,
the second one. Why is Glorious Pop by the Maokai?
Well, he was doing his sort of scare tactic with the looks of it. He wasn't going to actually get anything with that. He just wanted to show them, you
Cho'gath
know, that he can.
The Beast goes down pretty early. He decides to.
Well, Jinx has no peel whatsoever right now. Yeah,
no HP, in fact. This game, I think it's safe to say, is over.
It's over, yep.
Thresh coming back a little, you know, too little too late, my friend.
He is also actually going to be taken down.
Basically cost them the last team fight. And you fall down into base. Like,
too late.
That's great.
Just a little
again,
too late.
You need to work on your timing, matey.
Okay, so that was Team Potatoes taking that victory.
Team Potatoes is now going 1-1 in the tournament. Team Brian, I'm not entirely sure.
I feel like the Lux pick was just not there. I don't know. It just
not
didn't
good.
Work.
Not effective. Take your pick, really. Like, the Lux pick just brought nothing to the table other than wave clear.
Yeah.
And when you were that far behind, like, you couldn't even kill the Baron empowered minions. So, you know, it was a bit bad, really.
I mean, you got to consider that Jarvan and Cho'gath dealt more damage to champions than the Lux did within the game, so like it just shows that it didn't work because there was just too much threat that could get onto Lux. Like, she was just be shut down. There's no way that she was going to actually be able to do anything against a Vi
like,
and
died
Diana.
Purely from the AoE that was targeted towards the Jinx because she was just that far behind. She had no items. Like, it just very poor game. We have been noticing quite a large discrepancy in the mid laners over the course of the tournament so far.
Yeah.
Where
definitely.
The solo laners just seem to be snowballing. There's no boring, you know, Dyrus sits in lane, dies a couple times, moans about it on stream. It's just kind of action-packed so far.
Yeah, I mean, we still have yet to see anything that's like, you know, them early level 1 invades or anything like that, but I imagine that at some point, surely during these next few like weeks, is it? I'm pretty sure it's this week, next week.
Yeah.
We've got, you know, there's got to be something. Someone's going to pull it out, I imagine. I feel that for these past 2 days, you know, it's been teams more getting to know their opponents and, you know, figuring out how their opponents play. Because once you figure out the play styles.
But to be fair, like, in a best of one series, you shouldn't be going in to figure out what they're like. You should be going in to win.
I guess that's a pretty good point.
It's going to be too little, too late when the enemy team's in the finals because they just played their game instead of trying to, you know, accommodate to yours.
Well, I think that's signing off for now. Then I guess.
Yeah, we're pretty much done for today.
So once again, tomorrow from 6 PM till
it finishes.
Technically, till it finishes. Usually, will it be around like 9:30
ish
GMT? So, Yeah. Have a good one, guys.
Yeah. Cheers for tuning in, and toodle pip.